In this video, you and I will be exploring five new and exciting electric reverse trikes. I'll compare two trikes that seem to sport many similarities to see which has the most bang for your buck. You'll also be delighted to see what's new with the iTank, the world's first electric trike with reverse, and the soon-to-be-released Arcimoto Racer. Every year is another year for new toys and tech. What awaits us this year? I'm Glenn, and let's get to it. We'll start our excursion with a comparison between the 2021 iTango and the Vigorous V28. As you can see, both trikes share similar designs, but which is the better value? The iTango HO has a 1200-watt motor and a 26-amp-hour battery. Those seem good enough, but what does that mean in terms of power? That's 28 miles per hour on max speed mode, with a range of 31 miles. If you are more of a budget shopper, there's a cheaper and less powerful iTango Classic as well. However, stacking that up against the Vigorous V28, you'll notice that the V28 has a more powerful 2000-watt motor and a 20-amp-hour battery. We're left with a max speed of 28 miles per hour with a range of 25 miles. Okay, so the numbers are pretty similar as well then. What about the features? Well, you may not be surprised when I tell you that they are also pretty similar. Both have nice headlights and taillights along with LCD dashboard displays. However, it is important to note that the iTango has a roll lock system that will keep the front tires locked, so you don't need to deploy the side stand. It also happens to have auto-adapting headlights, which will automatically turn on when visibility is affected. So maybe the price tags will help solve our quandary. Which is the better bang for your buck? Well, if you finance these trikes through the LA-based distributor Pico, you'll find that the iTango has a weekly payment of $29, while the Vigorous V28 is $35. That adds up in the long term, but is still ultimately negligible for the most part. So, maybe at the end of the day, it is more up to personal preference. Then again, if you're a bargain hunter, perhaps the choice is already apparent to you.
I'm Allie, and it's Mind's Eye Trivia Time. By looking at just these images, do you know what this is and where it's from? Leave the correct answer or your best guess in the comment section below. Four.
Up next, we thought we'd check back in with the iTank, since it's been a few years since our last report. Just like iTango, mentioned previously, the iTank comes from Duan. Duan is dedicated to three-wheeled scooters, and the iTank was the first from them. The iTank was designed with safety and durability in mind. It's a favorite because of its accessibility. The iTank is simple enough for anyone to use, and powerful enough for climbing steep hills. Perhaps more importantly, is that it is fun to drive. It has a stable center of gravity and 120 newton meters of torque mixed with a powerful 1500 watt motor. That makes for some fun times, with the assurance that you have control. A neat feature with the iTank is the side deflecting wheels that make turning easy as pie and nearly as pleasant. Another is the reliable disc brakes that will surely see plenty of use with a trike that has a max speed of 31 miles per hour and a max range of 100 miles. And if that isn't enough for you, the iTank can add itself among the very few trikes that can reverse. Perhaps not a major selling point for most, but another notch on Duan's belt regardless. Let us know in the comments if that is important to you. Having color variety is also nice, with availability in white, red, or black.
3.
Rounding the bend of this video is another, and the last, trike from Doen on this list. Although maybe a three-wheeled scooter is a better term, as the iLark seems to have taken serious inspiration from its two-wheeled friends. The design seems perfect for those who frequently move from place to place, or perhaps when running errands around town. To accommodate that, the iLark only weighs 63 pounds and folds, so it is easily carried around and stored. Of course, its slight build means that it only carries a 300-watt motor, but it doesn't need much more. The iLark makes do with its top speed of 15 miles per hour and range of 18 miles. It seems to be a perfect match for commuters just looking for an efficient ride to and from work. The three-wheel design helps with stability, and turning or swerving while riding does look fun. It seems to even have a little body control involved, akin to a Segway. Six colors of customization are even nicer to see than iTank's three. If you've liked what you've seen of Doen so far, then perhaps you'd like the Breeze from Barreline. It utilizes the same chassis technology from the Barreline F2A hybrid scooter. This trike looks to be a combination of go-kart and moped, packs a whopping 3,000-watt motor, and has a max speed of 43 miles per hour in its secondary driving mode. Getting to where you need with this three-wheeler seems like a breeze. Ramping up the tempo a bit, we come to a company that is heavily driven by global warming. They think that we must rethink how we eat, live, drive. Arcimoto believes in a transition to smaller EVs like the FUV. The FUV, or Fun Utility Vehicle, is a beautiful machine designed with a purpose. The base version is meant for consumers as a clean, affordable alternative to your current mode of transportation. The FUV does well at its purpose, too. It has a top speed of 75 miles per hour and a max city range of 102 miles. It has the power to keep up with its contemporaries, but also has the lithe frame of a snake serpentining through streets and trails alike. The FUV pollutes the air less, as it has an electric motor. Still, it also pollutes the street space less, allowing for more control. That's especially useful when dealing with the other models based on the FUV design. The Deliverator is a courier variant of the FUV that still has those spec numbers, but with a shift in the design, catering to those who work with their vehicles. Perhaps even more important than either of those two is the Rapid Responder, the emergency response variant of the FUV. This version is especially useful for those in medical, law, or firefighting. The Fire Department of Eugene, Springfield even deploys rapid responders, and they have some great things to say about it. The FUV and all its variants are certainly a viable consideration in the new market, and they offer unique help to people. Thank you. Before we close out and say our goodbyes, our Komodo has one other model that we haven't discussed yet. It still hasn't been released, but it has some bright prospects. The Roadster. It's almost like an announcement that we can be green-friendly and still have some fun. The Roadster shares the same platform as the previous models we mentioned, but with this model, our Komodo strips the top off and lets the wind blow through this reverse trike. The Roadster was designed to be a joyride, and with dual-motor front-wheel drive, it doesn't look like it disappoints. Not with a top speed of 75 miles per hour going for 102 city miles, although those are the metrics for the other models as well. And with the top half of this one not being in the picture, those numbers could very well change. An open concept isn't the only thing about the Roadster, though. Aside from the narrow slice of windshield, tandem seating similar to a motorcycle, and some cargo space over the rear wheel accompany this motor trike. It's certainly an interesting design, but unfortunately, we don't have much more information than that. We'll be interested to see what our Komodo has to say in the next few months. And if you are too, well, tune back in. We could be doing an update. Until then, though, we'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments on the trikes we went over. Which one was your favorite? And are you interested to see more of the Roadster?